You are exiles. We are the exiles. We are the fallen.
You made the decision to go after Strange Flesh. This is about one thing. This is about us being consumed by another race. Let's get them in a host body system so we can destroy them. You're a kingdom divided. You're good and evil. You are the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. To rectify that situation, you got to be turned up. It's how you know that you know Jesus. And if it doesn't add up to the scriptures, then it's not true. All right, guys. God bless you guys. Welcome to This Is It. 4, 3, 2, 1, before the fire. Let's go. Guys, are you ready? Are you ready? I'm serious. Are you ready? You better get ready. We're going to tear down the fabric of the false reality that the whole world is living in. I'm not joking. I'm not just saying that glibly or just, No. I'm looking right at you. We are going to tear down the fabric of the false reality that we've been living in. We've been living in a false reality. I'm going to prove it. One thing that's occurred to me and that the Lord showed me, which is just beyond the human brain, is remember Detective Spooner's badge number 4084? Yes, his badge number 4084 in the Bible means to apprehend, catch, and arrest. That's what a detective does. So, for a detective in a movie called I, Robot, to have a badge number that's 4084, and for that number in the Bible to mean I apprehend, catch, and arrest. Now, that's either one crazy, crazy coincidence, or it's woven into the fabric of the system that you're in, which this is how I'm going to show you. It's a non-reality. Okay, now, if I was able to take that same paradigm and say, okay, look, you may think that it's just over here in Detective Spooner, his badge number, but no. It shows it takes place in Chicago in 2035. And 2035 in the Bible means like insurrection takeover. What happens in the movie I, Robot? An insurrection and takeover. Okay. Well, then, well, what about the Adobe Wawa commercial? It's about the beast being unleashed, and the entire commercial has the same thing going on the license plate and numerology that says, you know, upheaval, tumultuous upheaval, and the whole commercial fits the identical paradigm of Detective Spooner's badge. Now, I'm able to look the numbers up on the license plate, and there they are right there in the Bible, and it says exactly what is going on in the commercial. Now, you know that's not possible, right? You know that's just insane to a degree. However, if our Creator allowed you to go into a system that's a forbidden fruit, don't do it. If you choose to go in there, you get a body, but then you're in a system, kind of like a video game. You choose your character, you go in, you have your character, like your skin suit in the game, and you do your thing. But if you don't get, you just like David Bowie, if you don't find out who the serial killer is, then you lose the essence of your character within the system. Now, I'm going to prove to you, I'm going to show you over and over again, we're working on a video that shows you the language of angels, which is what the Lord God taught me. It is a language. It's just beyond reality because the reality that people think they're in, which is the world, is a non-reality. When you know the truth, then you're living in reality. That's why Jesus said, you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. Here's the truth. You're an angel and you've been inverted. You came into the system, the game, and you got your skin, your flesh suit, like your skin for the game. You came in, you got it, but your essence has been inverted and you don't know the truth. In order to see the truth, you have to invert the entire world. When you do that, you'll see there's a whole nother thing going on right in front of you, and it's woven into the very fabric of the system that you're in. So until you invert it all, you're not living in reality. You're living a false reality by definition. Now, the Bible says in the end, because they had pleasure in unrighteousness, God will send them strong delusion. So if you don't want to change and you're not willing to admit who you are and what you've done, God's like, okay, you know what? Then I'm going to send you strong delusion that you will believe the lie. You know what the word delusion means? It means even though someone is presenting to you absolute truth, like here's the guy that murdered so-and-so, here's his picture, here he is on a CCTV, here he is shooting the person, here's a close-up of his face, he happened to drop his wallet at the scene, we got the wallet, his driver's license, and here he is on video, here he is with the gun, here's his driver's license, and then his mom stopped and picked him up from the scene, and there's her car with her license plate because his mom didn't want him to get in trouble. I mean, I'm being facetious to try and make it stupid obvious. It's like, okay, he's the one that did it. There's no plausible deniability. This is what happened. But still, being presented with all that, someone, oh no, I don't believe it. Imagine presenting the world, well, guys, the bombings of the Twin Towers, the Twin Towers is printed on your $20 bill. Why? How? How'd they do that? And look, on the backside of the bill is the Pentagon. How? Why? Well, see, if your brain wants to, you go into a self-survival mode. So your brain will say, oh my God, it's too much for your brain and your psyche to handle. So you'll go into a self-preservation mode and you won't allow yourself to receive the truth because it will destroy everything you believed your entire life. And you probably can't handle that. Most people can't. Remember in the Matrix where Morpheus tells Neo, hey, I'm sorry I woke you up. We usually don't try and free anyone past a certain age because their brain has trouble letting go. Why does the Bible say whoever tries to save his life will lose it? Whoever loses his life for my sake will have life and have eternal life. We'll find true life and have eternal life. Because see, the people, when you present them with, hey, look, here the Twin Towers are on the $20 bill. Here's the Pentagon. And they're like, oh, whatever. Well, wait a minute. I'm showing you actual facts. Well, here's the federal building bombing on the old 20. So you can't sit there and go, well, no, that's not. Well, you can say the words, but it doesn't change the fact that that's what it is. So if you're willing to dismiss it, you're trying to preserve yourself. You're trying to preserve your brain and, oh my God, what does that mean for me if it's all been a lie? What does that mean? So everything's been a lie. So see, then you have to deal with it. And most people aren't willing to deal with it. Kind of like the Matrix when he said they're so plugged in, they become so inert, so dependent on the system that they'll even fight to preserve it. Okay, ready? Here we go. Y'all ready? Okay, I'm going to show you a couple little short videos that Zach and I worked on. Zach and I and Dave the Wave. And then I'm going to go back and show you some other little shorties that I've shown you. I'm going to open up a folder, and then we're going to talk about a movie called Free Guy. It's like, you want to be free? The end of the world is at the door. And I'm saying this from someone that lives in absolute reality. I've been converted. The Lord God has used me to lay hands on people that are terminally ill. They get well. People that are blind, they've received their sight back. I mean, people that are legally blind, people that have incurable eye problems. And there's getting to be a pretty good list of people that the Lord God has had me lay hands, because a supernatural, think about it, is God is like a video game player and he's outside the system and then he's got control of me and he sends me to a person and says, well, Johnny's got these powers, lay hands on this person and they get well. He sends me somewhere else, lay hands on this person, they get well. And then he's got another power, open up this book and you're going to solve who did this or who did that, or I'm going to show you what the Statue of Liberty is really about. I'm going to give you this superpower. That's just kind of a good way of thinking about it. Okay, keep that in mind, because the people that don't want to believe this, even though they're presented with the absolute facts, I'm showing you facts. I've got 70,000 images that prove everything I've been saying is true. So if you're going to call me a false prophet or a liar, that's okay. That's your self-defense mechanism, trying to hang on to your own life because you don't want to give it away, because then you'll have to change. And the change means you get converted And then you have another server that runs you completely and wholly. Right now, you're in between. You're double-minded. You have a server that goes up to God and a server that goes down to Satan. You're double-minded. Bible says, cleanse your hearts, you double-minded. Cleanse your heart. So see, you have to let your heart say, oh, you know what? Okay, that's it. I'm done. I can't live with it anymore. I don't want to be good and bad. I'm sorry. Forgive me. I did this, and just admit it. You don't think the Lord God knows everything you've done? You don't think Satan's keeping a record of everything you've done? When you admit it, it destroys the record. Don't you get it? So you admit what you did, and then that cuts the line to the pit, and then your eyes become singles, and the record against you is destroyed because Satan's no longer attached to you. The Lord's given me the greatest gift to give all of humanity. Just receive it. The truth. You were inverted. Coming into the system. You're an angel. Have I not said ye are gods? But all of you will die like men. I have said ye are gods. You are Elohim, angels. I'll say it again. I have said ye are gods. You are Elohim, angels. Psalm 82. It's not arguable. Who can equalize that which Elohim has turned upside down? Can't argue with that. That's the word of God. Elohim turned you upside down because when you came into the system, you're Elohim and you're inverted. That's all there is to it. Okay, you ready? Let's do it. What number is he holding up? What number? Is that just a, does this mean peace? And somebody shows you that and that means peace to you and you go, hey, peace back? Peace is what? Hey, two? Here's what peace is to me. I've been made whole. Not two. I've been made whole. One in Christ. Shema, O Israel, for the Lord thy God is one. Not two. One. You ready? I love you guys. I can't wait to show you. You ready? Y'all ready? Please just receive the truth. Okay, here you go. Ready? Let's watch a shorty. Statue of Liberty. Skeleton underneath the clothing.
Kind of makes you wonder, doesn't it? Wonder what? Whether she's naked under that toga.
Statue of Liberty represents our host body and the host body system on top of an 11-pointed star called a Hendecagram that represents our naked bodies.
She's French.
You know, it's midnight. Let's go, Venkman.
Here's something off the request line from Liberty Island. We gotta squeeze some New Year's juice from you, Big Apple.
New Year's juice he's referring to is semen, which is what set the beast from the pit free.
You know you're
The song, Your Love is Lifting Me Higher, is just euphemistic. The Vatican has angels melting into semen, and that semen is going into the serpent, and that is no different than the song, Your Love, your semen that's being consumed by the serpent race, is lifting me higher out of the pit. There it is. The angel's energy was used to unleash the female from the pit.
Man, I can't wait to see people's faces when we come on shore!
Can't you go any faster?
I'm afraid the vibrations will shake her to pieces. We should have padded her feet.
I don't think they make Nikes in her size, Ray.
Oh, don't worry, she's tough. She's a Harvard chick!
So the whole concept is, the semen, which is the angel light energy, is what was used to unleash the monster, the female, from the pit. That's what this whole segment is about. So,
the juice is loose.
Okay, so now I want to explain something very quickly to you. All I did was take a little segment of Ghostbusters where the Statue of Liberty comes free of her stand, which is the 11-pointed star, the Hendecagram, which represents your host body, and the statue, which is your host body, that was used to take all the angels and put them in a statue, which is your body, like in the game you're in, which is life, the game of life. So all that energy that came into every host body that didn't get converted went to the pit to free the angel of the bottomless pit. Well, where does he go? Into all the bodies that are walking around at that time. And his energy goes into them and he's set free into them. That's why they'll have their ruler and the host body that's going to be the one running them, and they'll be of one mind. And without getting into side stories, I've been dealing with it on a level that would blow your freaking mind. Okay, now let's watch another little shorty, but then I'm going to go back and comment on these. Why do you think they would have the Statue of Liberty in Ghostbusters with, let's just be honest, is that semen on the inside of the Statue of Liberty dripping down all the infrastructure of the statue? Of course it is. Is there pink electricity going through all of it? Of course it is. Are they playing the song Your Love, meaning the angels coming into the system, inseminating the other race, is lifting me higher? Of course it is. So let me ask you a question. What is reality? I mean, what is it? You think the Ghostbusters thing is just some, hey, I got a great idea. We'll have the Statue of Liberty just break free, and yeah, it'll be really funny, and then we'll have her walk down the streets in New York. Yeah, and I'll mention, yeah, I should have gotten her some tinnies like Nike. Why would you say that? Because Nike's the goddess of victory. See, the whole thing is not at all a movie Ghostbusters. It's really about the angel of the bottomless pit getting free. That's what it's about. That's reality. So I'm tearing down the false fabric of bullshit and saying, let's get to it. What are you doing with a statue with a bunch of sperm in it? What? Why is there electricity going throughout all the sperm? That's freaking stupid. But you know what? It's true, because she's standing on top of the kelopot, the 11-pointed star. The star that's in the dead center represents the angel, the semen that came in, because you're light energy. And if you look at the little images that we put in here, we put the Vatican. What's going in the mouth of the serpent? Angels, what are they turning into? Semen. What's in the Statue of Liberty? Semen. What's the Statue of Liberty represent? The angels that took the liberty to take on those bodies. That's reality. Why do you think even the little poem about the Statue of Liberty talks about the giant new colossus that Twin Cities frame? I mean, do y'all know what the colossus was in Greece? It's like, come on, guys. It's okay. Ready? Let's do another one real quick. Yeah, why? What about Beetlejuice? Hang on. The juice is loose. Oh, that's really great. I love the idea. Like a ghost guy will float up, you know, from down below. It'll be Michael Keaton, and he'll look all stupid and weird. And like, you know, he's wearing like a prison suit, because, you know, the angel of the bottomless pit comes from the prison he's been locked up in, because he's been locked up in the abyss. And he's going to come out. But why do they call him Beetlejuice? Here's another question. Why does the word Beetlejuice split into twin words? Because I live in reality and I know exactly what's going on here now. Why is there a building called the Twin Towers? Why is the Twin Towers printed on your $20 bill being destroyed? Why was the Twin Towers destroyed? Isn't it weird? We're in a twin system, Cain and Abel, Jacob and Esau. The younger twin shall rule over the elder twin. That's why they hate us. They know it's coming. Watch. Let's do this. Ready? Some questions to ask, right? Okay, so the juice is loose with commentary. And then let's do this real quick. Ready? The twin system. Ready?
Have you ever noticed the twin paradigm in the world? If you haven't, you have to see it. It's way more significant than you'd think. Check out these clips.
That was good. I just need one more.
Brett, right?
No, I need one more.
Yeah, one more.
Just one more.
X.
No, I would say exactly.
I think we need to change the lens.
Yeah, change it up.
We need a 35 mil.
35 mil, please.
Maybe he wants me to what? To get confused. Oh, I'm already confused, Pilgrim. Plenty confused. So don't talk to me about confusion. Wait a minute now, back up just a sec. What about that?
There's a killer on the road.
Seconds ago, we gave Ian Rappaport a Bud Light and a choice. Ian is not an actor. He has no idea what's going to happen next.
I think I could do that.
Hey, Don, how are you?
Hey, how's it going?
Nice to see you.
Are we wearing the same coat? Yeah, nice jacket.
Twins?
Yes.
This is a bizarre night.
Take care, Ian.
Everyone here is a twin?
My mind is blown.
We got twins! Twins!
The juice is loose.
I'm gonna pause it right there. See right there on the corner of our eye? Look right there. They did that on purpose as well. You see that? Now it's a teardrop. It's a shadow. Making a teardrop on purpose. This whole thing we're in is an illusion. Now remember, I told you, the Lord told me a long time ago, this is how you're going to read the Bible from now on. You're going to read it and translate on the fly. He showed me the word in Genesis 1, let us create man in our image. Elohim said that. Remember now, here's Proverbs 25. It is the glory of Elohim to conceal a matter. It's their glory to conceal it. Genesis 1, Elohim said, let us create man in our image. That was the twin system being created. In the image of Elohim created he him, male and female created he them. So the system is dualistic. Cleanse your hearts, you double-minded. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways, and he can expect nothing from the Lord. Woe to them who go to great depths to hide their plans from the Lord. Their works are in the darkness, which is down. And they say, who seeth us and who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay, which is what the Lord God formed in Genesis 2. So see, everything I'm telling you is perfection because it's not me that did it. The Lord God gave it to me to give to you. Isn't it weird? My name means Yahweh has given. That's what Jonathan means. And I only found that out because I was having a total meltdown because I was freaking out at my supernatural abilities. And I was like, what's going on? Why are you showing me this stuff? The Lord told me to open a book I had on my counter. It's called ABCs of the Bible. I've shown it to you. And it said, the ancient Israelites believed that names had mystical powers and meanings and reflected the character and destiny of a person. Children were named at birth, except for boys, 8 days later at the time of circumcision. Parents would name their children showing trust and an appellation in God. For instance, Jonathan means Yahweh has given. What do I do? Well, I give you everything Yahweh gives me. So the one that's outside of the game, you know, kind of like if you're sitting there playing a video game, the one that is outside of the game that's running the whole show, he's the one that's having me lay hands on whoever he wants me to lay hands on. He's the one that gives me all the information. It's not me. I'm not that smart. As a matter of fact, the Bible says, I'll use the things this world considers foolishness to confound the wise. That would be me. My life never really made any sense. I did a lot of pretty wild things, but nothing really adds up to anything unless you end up knowing the truth. Because at the end of the game, at the end of the game of life, when it comes full circle, if you haven't been converted, then guess what happens to you? Your energy, your soul goes to the pit and you're consumed. You're assimilated by a race of locusts. And guess what happens to them? They're burned. Eternal destruction. I'm just trying to help get you out of here, because I believe it looks like, from what I can just understand the best of my ability, I'm going to show you, I believe that we've come full circle, and there's no, I don't know the hour, the day, the month, or the year, but I can assure you of this. The Lord just showed me within the last 12 hours, I guess, about 24 hours, we've come full circle. I'm going to show you how he showed me. And you guys do what you want with it. I'm just a delivery boy. That's it. I'm just going to give you guys what he gives me, and you guys do what you want with it. I love you in Christ. I'm going to help open your eyes. See the teardrop? Where do we see teardrops? On the dead sheep, remember? Hey, Johnny, I drew a picture of you. Why did you draw a picture of me, Alex? That's super weird. Why would you draw a picture of me? Well, because I had to draw a dead sheep on you, because we're the serpent race and we hunt you all day long, you know, hunted for dinner, Johnny. So I drew a picture of you because you're a sheep and the serpent that's in me is hunting you. And so when I drew your picture, I drew a sheep on your face so I could make it obvious that I'm the serpent hunting you. You know, no big deal. Well, it's the same as the Vatican. Vatican's a big snake eating a sheep. Might as well. Well, it's the same as downtown Grand Junction. That girl that's hugging that guy, you know, on Main Street. Well, when he's hugging her, but she's really a serpent that's killing him. He turns into a dead sheep. I just figured it's cool. See what I mean? It's stupid obvious now. It's not even obvious. It's stupid obvious. You think that shadow teardrop just happened on accident? No. Do you think it turned into twins because it's not a twin system? And do you think maybe the message is Beetlejuice, you know, like semen that gets the insects out of the pit? Beetlejuice, the juice is loose. Okay, already, I get it. I get it. Okay, now, let me show you some coming full circle. I just want you to see some imagery. So here's a good image of coming full circle. You know, it starts in one place and then it does a full rotation. Well, that's interesting, because this very thing is what's on a table in one of the shipping containers that the Lord had me do, literally this exact same thing. It's pretty crazy. But, you know, just, we have come full circle. I'm just giving you guys this little imagery of just, you know, kind of looks like the Ouroboros, doesn't it? Kind of looks like an infinity symbol, doesn't it? Sure does. Okay, now let me just go back and let's talk about something. Okay, here's the Statue of Liberty, and I use this gift just to show you, when you take the robe off her, she's really death. The Statue of Liberty. Because you took the liberty. Did you get your shoes? Was YG super cool and got a pair of bait tennis shoes that say, fuck you, pay me? You know, with Lost Angel on the heel that's on top of snake skin. Yeah, I'll show them to you because we're going to go through the folder. Just come on. Okay, let me ask you a question. Why do you think they would say in that clip, kind of makes you wonder what, if she's naked what was the whole beginning of the Bible about? Wasn't it about us being naked? Well, in order to do the thing with the female, we had to take on suits of skin in order to do that, and we were naked. Why would he say, do you think she's naked under that? Well, let me show you the Statue of Liberty from above. See the Statue of Liberty? She's kind of inside a box. See the square right there? But I want to show you this. You see this two triangles up here? And then when you count these points, that's an 11-pointed star. It's called a hendecagram. I want you to look at Baphomet. See the triangle here and the triangle here? One here and one here. One here and one here. It's an interesting star because it's got an odd number of points, so it's not symmetrical. Up here, there's two. There's one, two. And down here at the bottom, at the 6 o'clock point, is one. Because it's after a cycle, the two become one. And that's what happens to all of us. Your energy, if you don't get converted and go home to heaven, then you go to the pit and the two become one in their world, a locust. So you're going from one, heaven, into a dualistic system. If you don't get converted, down to the pit, you become one with them. Another angel comes down, boom, in the system. System goes around, boom. He didn't get converted, boom, down to the pit, you become one. Another one comes in, he's going through the, oh, he gets converted, he gets turned up. So he lives out his life, but then he goes back to heaven. And he knows, each one learning by never learning a kiss. Y'all know where that's from? The CIA challenge coin, remember? Ooh, usque quamque. Yeah, my brain's going blank on the Latin that's on the coin. Y'all remember? Each one learning by never learning a kiss. Neither shall you touch it, lest you die. Okay, here we go. Statue of Liberty. What does it represent? Well, right here, it represents taking on the flesh. See, there's a Baphomet, the goat god. He's got a boob and a wanker. And the whole thing is the flesh. And what's in the dead center? Take a look right here. What's in the dead center? See the flame coming out? And see how it's going opposite directions? And what is it? It's two serpents coming face to face. So it's like DNA, but it's burning. Well, the Bible says in Genesis 3, neither shall you touch it. And the word touch means to burn, because it will burn you. You will be engulfed by it, and lest you die. And then there you are in the middle. You're the 5-pointed star that's being burned in the center of it. You're the energy that this system is burning. And the Statue of Liberty is a perfect statue for those that run the system to mock the crap out of you. And don't forget, she's looking east where life begins. East is the looking towards life and the rising of Helios. Because in their pagan religions, she looks towards the east, waiting for the personification of the sun, Helios. Okay, now here we go.
Statue of Liberty represents our host body and the host body system.
Okay, now you see that right there? The Statue of Liberty is standing right on top of this. This is what she's standing on top of, this exact 11-pointed star. See the two yellow triangles? Okay, well, you see the star in the middle? That's you. And see the right side up, upside down triangle? That's the system that's hers. Right side up, upside down. And guess what? That right there is going to grind you out to a singularity in the end, and you're going to go to the pit unless you get converted. There it is, right there in front of you. Looking right at it. Go look up Pendecagram. Go look up Kelipot. Q-L-I-P-O-T-H, if you need to spell it, Q-L-I-P-O-T-H. Just go research it. Kabbalistic Jews, they know it's a host body system. They're the mystic Jews. Here we go. Triangle, triangle. The two become one. So it looks like the letter M, right? And the letter M becomes one. And the male energy that comes into it, which represents you, the male energy turns into female energy. All female energy, it consumes you. That's why the group Milli Vanilli, that were total losers, total shams, total phonies. Their logo is exactly the Indecagram top and bottom. Let me show you. Okay, so at the end of the cycle, here we go. So I'm going to show you the end of the cycle. Here's the Indecagram. Here's the eyes going opposite direction. Red eye going this way. Blue eye going this way. It's the twin female system. Look at the two different triangles up here. One here and one here. This represents your duality. It's the female twin system. Here's the force up. There's the force down. There's the star in the middle. The male energy in the middle. I want you to look at, see Millie right here. Look, let me stretch it out here. Let me go right here. See the M right here? Look right here. See the M? And you see the V? See the V right here? So M and V. And these guys were the biggest posers. But the thing about them is they're both feminine looking, which is okay. I mean, it's okay. There's male and female energy in all of us. But see, they're being used to make the point. Even the logo for their name, the M and V, that the Indecagram turns male into female. That's why they got two guys that couldn't sing to save their ass, but they could dance around and they were pretty. You get it? Millie Vanilli. And then also their names are very important. I put them in a folder. It's just insane, but you're looking at absolute truth. You see the M and the V? Is that an M right there? Just like that? Is that a V? Yes? It's like not arguable. So going through Baphomet's female energy system. Energy, don't forget. Energy, but male and female as opposing forces. The female energy sets the host body trap. Now watch.
Represents our host body and the host body system on top.
Okay, you see the sperm swimming here? You see these two triangles right here at the top? Picture the sperm going in between them, kind of like that would be the labia, and then the sperm goes into the dead center. Like this is a female egg in a way. This is the whole sexual thing. And the sperm goes in, and there it is in the dead center of the star. See it? And so this represents the trap that the light, and now don't forget, each sperm is light energy going into the trap. That's what they're after, the essence of life. Where does it come from? El, the Almighty God. I will rise above the stars of El. Isn't that what Lucifer said? I will arise above the stars of El. Ready? A star of El. That's one of God's princes. Well, how do you rise above it? Well, you set a host body system trap here at the boundary, the earth. The angel comes into the system. So he comes from above and he comes into the host body. Now he's attached to a demon, and that demon is attached to the pit. And then Satan destroys him and sends him to the pit. And he just arose above the angels of El. I will arise above the stars of El. So you get one of the stars of El, an angel in a host body. You send him to the pit, and you did rise above him. That's exactly what they're doing. Okay. Let's tear down their little fake party. I mean, it's so obvious now. Here we go.
Top of an 11-pointed star called a Indecagram that represents our naked bodies.
She's French.
You know, it's midnight. Let's go, Venkman.
Here's something off the request line from Liberty Island.
Okay, so here's something off the request line from Liberty Island. See, we're on an island we call the Earth. This is where we're at. Just like Taylor Swift, the song, Are You Ready For It? Doesn't she say, we can go to an island, turn the lights down low, no one has to know? You're hiding from God. You took the bait. You're on the island. We can turn the lights down low, to shade. Genesis 1, to shade. Turn the lights down low, to shade. No one has to know. You turned away from God. You get it? Tearing down the fabric.
We gotta squeeze some New Year's juice from you.
Okay, so we gotta squeeze some New Year's juice from you. And then he says, Big Apple. Doesn't the apple represent the fall? You know, even though it's not an apple. We have to squeeze some New Year's juice from you, Big Apple. What do you think they're talking about? Well, the way you know what they're talking about is then the scene cuts away to the inside of the Statue of Liberty dripping with semen. So I think it's pretty obvious maybe, huh? Or no?
We gotta squeeze some New Year's juice from you, Big Apple.
New Year's juice. Now right here it says, juice is loose. The juice is loose. And I put the Beetlejuice little clip here because it's no different than what you're watching in the Statue of Liberty right now. The Statue of Liberty is getting up off her freaking pedestal and she's walking now, representing the pit opening up because all the semen that's gone into her, representing the female system, has opened the pit. Do you get it? It's so stupid obvious. It's like, yeah, this is stupid obvious now, yeah. The juice is loose. What juice? The beetle juice. What comes out of the pit? Insect race, right? Beetle juice. Why did it split into twins? Gee, I don't know. Okay, let's do it.
Juice from you, Big Apple. We gotta squeeze some New Year's juice from you, Big Apple.
New Year's juice he's referring to is semen, which is what set the beast from the pit free.
Okay, look what they showed you. Walk man. See it? Do you think we needed to see that there's a walk man? They're showing you walk man. And what's that walk man playing, I wonder? Your semen is lifting me higher right out of the pit. That's what it's playing. Your love is lifting me higher. Your semen is lifting me up out of the pit because the Statue of Liberty is just a representation of the host body standing on top of the kelipot. All the Kabbalistic Jews know it, and they're running the show. Whoa, is that your love right there? Oh, my gosh. That's a whole lot of love. Better call Led Zeppelin. Kata Dynasteo. Okay, come on. So fucking stupid. It's like, okay, I feel really stupid. I feel like I'm the last to know. Okay, you know, here, watch. Let's watch this one more time. Ready? Here we go. Ready? Just watch. Tell me, is this semen or did someone just spit a big hawker in her? Or what is it? What's all the goo in the Statue of Liberty? Why is Walkman on the wall? It's like, okay, click, I get it. Just trying to make a point. Okay, here we go.
The song Your Love is Lifting Me Higher is just euphemistic. The Vatican has angels melting into semen, and that semen is going into the serpent, and that is no different than the song, Your Love, Your Semen That's Being Consumed by the Serpent Race is Lifting Me Higher Out of the Pit. There it is. The angel's energy was used to unleash the female from the pit.
Man, I can't wait to see people's faces when we come on shore!
Can't you go any faster?
I'm afraid the vibrations will shake her to pieces. We should have patted her feet.
I don't think they make Nikes in her size.
Okay, now, do you think we shouldn't, we really need to know? I hope her feet aren't getting hurt. Gee, we should have made Nike. We should have made Nike t-shirts. Goddess of Victory. Make sure you get that in there, guys. I mean, what about Lady Gaga's Stupid Love? You know, the bear trap right in front of her lips with kind of all the sticky stuff on the trap. I mean, what is sex anyway? I mean, is that love? The Bible tells us what love is. 1 Corinthians 13. I've learned what love is. I had to learn what love was. The love that I thought was love my whole life certainly wasn't love. And sex is not love. I thought sex was more of like a, you know, boy-girl full-contact sport type thing. But whatever. I mean, it's just what's going on here. I mean, seriously, what's going on? We've been bullshitted since the day we opened our little eyes here. No one knows what the hell's going on. It's a freaking breeding thing. It's a forbidden fruit. And they keep you in the dark because it's the glory of Elohim to conceal it. But they say it right in front of you all freaking day long in all their movies, all their songs, all their advertising. But they're laughing at you because they know you're in a trance because the male energy in you has been put to sleep. And the female energy's hunting your ass through those by system. But it doesn't matter if you're a boy or a girl, like if you got a wiener or a vagina. Doesn't matter. It's the energy. She is a monster from the pit. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And we are a combination of two different energies, good and evil. And it manifests through us. And we are an expression of those energies within a host body. However, your soul is yours. It's the only thing that you can open your mouth and say, I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to do this because I want to serve that king. I'm not going to let the other king live alongside the king that I love. I'm going to be totally devoted to one, not devoted to one and the other. No. I'm going to turn to one. Decide this day whom you will serve. If the Lord be God, then serve him. If Baal be God, then serve him. But choose this day whom you will serve. You get it? I want to serve the Lord. Me and my house will serve the Lord. Uh-huh. No more full contact sport. outside the covenant of marriage.
Oh, don't worry. She's tough. She's a Harvard chick. I'm afraid the vibrations will shake her to pieces. We should have padded her feet.
I don't think they make Nikes in her size, Ray.
Oh, don't worry. She's tough. She's a Harvard chick.
Okay, now, did you see? Okay, now, very important now. She just crushed the cop car, right? Yes or no? Crushed it. But it was at a corner, like, but what was written on the wall? Let's go see, because I saw this, but I haven't looked it up, but I know it's important.
Wow. Check!
Okay, look, Fred. Okay, I don't see an obvious police car number. If there was a number on that police car, I would be like, that's probably important. They put it there for a reason. Let's look up the meaning of the name Fred. Okay, let's do that. Okay, so meaning, meaning of name Fred. Come on, shut the F up. Look. Meaning of name Fred is peaceful ruler. See, Fred, like the corner. Let's crush him. What's going on right now in the world? Well, they anti-police, anti-peace, really. The whole world is going for this hatred thing. Have you noticed? And the sea shall turn terrible before your very eyes, and the terrible one shall be elevated within the sea. And behold, the man of peace who came forth from the sea in 2008 shall come forth from the sea, and with words of peace he'll bring chaos and destruction. Could it be Barack Obama, lightning from heaven, maybe? Hey, guys. Look, peaceful ruler. But Nike, she should have a pair of Nikes. But the Statue of Liberty is what your host body is. It's the game we're in. It's the game of life. And all the semen that went into her system and got the angels turned into locusts is what's opening the pit for her to crush the peaceful ruler here in the system that we're in. Do you understand? Now you're seeing reality. Ghostbusters? That's so stupid. Ooh, let's go bust some ghosts. How about if we just show them how freaking blind they are in a movie called Ghostbusters? That'll be great. We'll laugh at them. Let's crush them.
So the whole concept is the semen, which is the angel light energy, is what was used to unleash the monster, the female from the pit. That's what this whole segment is about.
Okay, here you go.
The juice is loose.
The juice is loose. And look at the shadow teardrop. And let's do that one more time. The juice is loose. And I think I'm going to give you the image of that. Here you go. The juice is loose. See the, did you see the electricity and the juice that's loose? See, it was used as a medium, the medium. Do y'all remember Kehinde Wiley? He did the Obama presidential T-Rex portrait where Barack Obama is a T-Rex on one side of his head. Well, didn't he say on The View, well, we all have a reptilian part of our brain. I'm sure Kehinde Wiley will put it in my presidential portrait. We all have a reptilian part of our brain. Well, he's got a reptilian side of his head in the bushes. Why would you have a presidential portrait where the president's sitting in this weird-ass garden and Kehinde Wiley's being interviewed and he goes, well, I like to take little shots at masculinity, you know, so I put sperm in my painting. It's like, ooh, I like to take little shots at femininity, so I put buns on my hamburger. It's so stupid now. It's like, okay, shit. Do you feel like embarrassed when you like finally get something and you're like, what? It's like, yep. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. There you go. I mean, isn't I'm sorry, guys. I'm really sorry, but what you got him, you know, you got him. It's like, oh, yeah.
Oh. The song Your Love is Lifting Me Higher is just euphemistic. The Vatican has angels melting into semen, and that semen is...
There's the love that's lifting them higher right there. Angels coming into the serpent through the serpent flesh sex full contact sport system. There it is. Okay. Thanks for letting me. Sorry, guys. I'm in a mood. I'm like, I watched the movie Free Guy the other night. Okay. Last night. It was like, okay. Too obvious now. It's just ridiculous. Okay. Now, let's move on. There's the love that's lifting them higher out of the pit. And there you go. Crush the peaceful ruler here in the earth. That's the serpent's gig. And then it self-implodes. And once it self-implodes, it's all bad. Why do you think there's a band called Collective Soul? Because your love is lifting me higher. See, Collective Soul. There's where you go in. We're going to collect it. You're going to go down. And then your love is going to help. I will arise above the stars of hell by getting them in a host body, destroying them, getting into the pit, and then rising above them. That's how. No doubt. Now the Bible makes total sense. Now the dirt bags are caught. Let's talk about Samael for a minute. You know what? Let me show you a couple images first. I'm going to show you sheep. Okay, so I'm going to show you this sheep right here. You know what? Hang on. Let me just... I think I have a couple other images that I really want to just kind of make sure you see it first. So here you go. Watch this. So you see right here, you see the sheep right here. Let me just do this. Oh, wow. It's kind of small. Sorry about that. So y'all, you guys see the sheep right here? Yes or no? You see the sheep right here? There's the black sheep head and there's the white fur. Okay, so you can't see the eyes, but if I put an eye there and an eye there, there's the black head of a sheep, nose down here, ear here, ear here, and then the white fur there. So there you go. Now, let me show you the sheep right on the face of a character called Venom. So let me just go, let's see, let me, sorry about that. Let me grab it this side, and then I'll enlarge Venom. That's interesting. Let me go like that. And I'll just show it to you right there. How's that? There you go. There's the sheep. Why is there a sheep's head right on the face of Venom? Is Venom got just a really weird-ass tongue? Or is that a sperm going in his mouth? Well, I can tell you it's a sperm. You know how I know? Because Samael means Venom of El. That's what Samael means. Now, you remember the image of Baphomet, the goat god with the boob and the wanker, floating above the 11-pointed star, which is the Hendecagram, which is called the Kelepot, which is a shell, a peel, or a husk, which is your host body. Okay, so Baphomet is floating above the 11-pointed star, sucking up all the energy from the 11-pointed star, which is the angel trapped in the middle in a twin dualistic right side up, upside down system represented by the right side up triangle interlocked with the upside down triangle. And the stars in the dead center being destroyed by this system. That's why if your eye be single, your whole body's full of light because your eyes up and down, it's light and dark, and that's what destroys you. Double-mindedness. You get it? So you turn back to the Lord God. Now watch. Samael means the venom of El. Well, let's do Google Images, and I'm just going to guess. I'm going to write Samael satanic star and see what comes up. Well, by God, there's a few of them. Look at that. There's a few. There's a couple. Samael and Lilith. And there's the goat-headed god. So, see, Samael, venom of El. Well, what's the venom of El? An upside-down star, which represents the female energy from the pit. And what is this? Why is Lilith there? Well, because that energy from the pit started a host body system. And that host body system had a bunch of host bodies running around. And inside that host body system was the spirit of Elohim, the Ruach Elohim. That's what started the thing. The living soul didn't come until Genesis 2. So, Samael, venom of El, that is considered the angel that was inhabiting that host body system. And Lilith was considered his first squeeze, if you will. And then Lilith was considered to be Adam's first wife, because when Eve got impregnated by the serpent race, aka Samael, she was impregnated by the serpent. And then she did take to Adam and he did eat. The word eat, do you know what the word eat means? It means to burn. So when you join into a female that's of another race, you become your energy tied to hers. That's what burns the whole system. Two energies that one went in, tied to another one. That's what burns the system. And so then he has sex with Eve after that, after he has carnal knowledge. And guess what? She has heteropaternal superfecundation twins. Cain and Abel. In one race, the serpent race inside of you kills the sheep race inside of you. The evil inside of you kills the good inside of you. Your whole life. Unless you turn back and say, I'm sorry, because you're in a snare. You're in a slipknot. The harder you pull, the tighter it gets. Oh, there's a really twisted band called Slipknot, I think. Yeah, let's look this up. Okay, ready? Slipknot. Let's see who these guys are. Slipknot. Band. Let's see what happens. Ha! There you go. Look at that. Ha! Shut up. Okay, see that? Okay, two triangles at the top, one at the bottom. It's an abbreviated version of the Hendecagram. There it is. Look, Slipknot. You see the letter K? You know why the letter K is in the dead center? I do. I read their language. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. You know what K is? 11. You know what 11 is in the Bible? See, K is in the dead center? Watch this. Strong's 11. We got them. Their fabric is being destroyed right now. Their false reality is being ripped down by just... place of destruction and ruin. Oh, you guys are so radical. You're so cool. Your heavy metal music just... I don't know, man. It's just rad. Super rad. The harder I pull, it's like the tighter it gets. Well, don't pull anymore. Just turn the other direction, okay? Slipknot, douche. Stupid. Slipknot, there you go. Slipknot, get it? Place of destruction. What's a place of destruction? The host body, the Hendekagram. There you go. Oh, these guys look like some seriously nice guys. Yo, let's party, brah. Stupid. Uh-huh, there they are. Wait. Stop. I just want to thank Jesus for sponsoring us. Sorry. It's like, dude, it's so obvious. All right, let's keep going. Samael, Lilith, you see it? Samael, Lilith. Okay, let's get back to where we were. Okay, well, they crushed the peaceful ruler, Venom of El. Let's go back to the folder. Ready? Let's do it. I'm gonna show you the full circle. You ready? Because look, the Hendekagram, the host body system from the beginning of the fall. Every earth has a beginning and an end. We're talking about worlds without end. In perpetuity is what the Bible says. So from one earth age to the next, from one age to the next age of humans, that where it runs out of energy in the system and then it's destroyed. Like Shiva, the destroyer, you know, the female energy, they worship that because Shiva is the female energy that destroys, that comes out of the pit and destroys everything. Because once she takes over the whole host body system, everybody freaking kills everybody. There's no like, hey, we'll be evil friends all day long. It's like, No, they're not going to get along because the restrainer is taken out of the way. What's a restrainer? God's spirit. El spirit comes out. Okay, now watch this. Ready? Okay, now let's see. Let's just get into the pictures now. Here we go. Let's just do this in order. Okay, now watch this. Now I just got through showing you and proving that there's a serpent race and a sheep race. I've done it 1,000 times. Now watch this. Look at this. Let's go to that. But this is a people robbed and spoiled. All of them are snared, turned upside down in holes. They are hid in prison houses. You know what the word prison houses means? In the sense of separation, two heterogeneities. See that right here? Look right here. Look right here. In the sense of separation, two heterogeneities, diverse seeds, mingled seeds. The Bible just told you and me and the world, your prison house, which is your body, is a mingled seed. Can you argue with it?
Well, I don't believe you because I'm really locked into my quartz crystal. It's really cool. And if I believe you, well, then I got to get rid of all my quartz crystals. You see what I'm saying? I'm just trying to be a smart ass. See, oh no, I can't look at that. I may have to think. Oh, wait a minute. You mean my body is a mingled seed? That's my prison house? Uh-huh. And the Twin Towers is on your $20 bill. It's like, oh shit. Okay, somebody give me the bong quick. I gotta do some thinking. It's like, seriously. Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying, what are you gonna do with this? What are you gonna do? In the sense of separation. Separation from who? Oh, I get it now. Mingled seeds from full contact sports. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's keep going. Let's see. Here's one that cracks me up. This is the one where I've actually had people say, Kleck, this proves you're a false prophet. Okay, now let's do a little logic. I love logic. I want to play the scene from Monty Python where they say, she's a witch. That's like, it's my favorite logic. No, so check it out. Are there angels in heaven, yes or no? It's a yes or no. Are there angels in heaven, yes or no? Are there angels that have been kicked out of heaven, yes or no? Well, the answer to both is yes. There's angels that are in heaven, and there's angels that have been kicked out of heaven. I'm one of those angels. You know how I know? Because the Lord told me, live out your life as an exile. You know what an exile is? Someone that's been kicked out of their country of origin for punitive reasons, usually for political or, you know what? Let's look at the exact definition. Ready? Okay, well, that's pretty darn close.
Exile. Exile.
A state of being barred from one's native country, heaven, typically for political or punitive reasons. You mean like an insurrection? Or you wanted to go after strange flesh? And so you got put in exile. Punitive or political reasons, like an insurrection. What does the Bible say? Live out your life as what? Say what? Exiles. What's an exile? Well, I'm living my life out as an exile because that's what God told me I'm supposed to do. Oh, I've been kicked out of my country of origin. Where's that? Frankfurt. No, heaven. For political or punitive reasons. Strange flesh. Full contact sports. Uh-huh. That's it. So there you go. Now, so, but we see Jesus, who was made a little lower than the angels. Well, did you see that right here it says the word Jesus? Let's go to Hebrews 2:9. You ready to freak out? You want to freak out? I want to freak out. So we're going to go to Hebrews 2:9. Okay, ready? We'll go to Hebrews 2:9. Y'all having fun yet? It's like, oh shit. Sorry guys. Hebrews chapter 2 verse 9. Okay, here we go. Ready? But we see Jesus right here. Ready? Get ready. Oh, wow. I don't like big pink for Jesus. Let's do a different color altogether. There we go. Jesus, what does it say? It is of Hebrew origin. Please say this out loud. Of Hebrew origin. What's his name? Jesus. When I see these lunatics, oh, it's Zeus. No, it's juice. It's so stupid. Have you ever seen the people that do whole videos? Oh, Jesus is Zeus. They say it with a straight face. God bless their little hearts. It's Jesus because it's a Greek word. It's pronounced Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, it is of Hebrew origin from Hebrew word 3091, yes or no? 3091, yes or no? It says Jesus, that is Yehoshua, yes or no? Okay, well, see, Jesus is of Hebrew origin, and it means Yeho and Shua. I already know what it means. I'm going to tell you now, then I'm going to show you. Yeho means the self-existent, eternal Yehovah. And Shua means that redoubles your eyes by opening wide your dungeon, your body. Okay, so now everything in the world just got proven. I mean, I said it, but I haven't shown it to you yet. I'll say it again. Yeho, like Yehoshua, Yeho means the self-existing eternal Jehovah. Shua means that opens wide the dungeon that you're in, your body, by redoubling your eyes. So now the mystery of everything solved according to the word. Now I'm going to show it to you. Ready? So, let me ask you this. Did the self-existent eternal Jehovah, did he come down into a body called Jesus, yes or no? Well, duh, he got hung on a cross and killed for our duality. Why do you think he died on the cross? For your duality. One guy on each side of Jesus, you know, the good guy, the bad guy. One guy was a real dick and the other guy was like, I deserve my punishment. That's you. And he's going to reconcile both to God through the cross. So Jesus is Yehoshua. Well, when he came down into his host body, was he made a little lower than the angels that are still in heaven? It's a yes or no. Okay, Clegg, you got me on logic. You logicked me. It's not fair. Of course he was made a little lower than the angels. And then he came to save the angels that were trapped in the host body system, which is you. You get it? I do. Ready? Let's see what Yehoshua means. Ready? So the Yeho part is 3068. See, it says Yehoshua right here. So you see the Yeho? That's this word. What does it say in the box? Yehovah. The self-existent eternal Jehovah. Yes or no? That's what it says. So Jesus is the self-existent eternal Jehovah. And then Yasha. Properly to open wide. Causatively to set free, preserve, rescue, be safe. By redoubling your eyes. In the dungeon you're in called your Gelapot that the Statue of Liberty is standing on. He's made a little lower than the angels. Hey, guys, I know I rule heaven and all, but I'm going to go in the form of a man, even though I'm going to exist in heaven at the same time. I'm going to go in, and when I go in, I'm going to be in a host body called Jesus. I'll be down there. Don't worry. I'll be here at the same time, too, though. Don't worry about it. I'm going to go down a cross down there to try and get our brothers that got trapped in the flesh so they don't get turned into a freaking bug. By the female energy trap. Yeah. It's pretty perfect, right? So see, Yehoshua, he was made a little lower than the angels for the suffering of death, crowned with glory. So why do you think he's the name above all names? You know why he's self-existent? Because El, the Almighty God, is the head of all the angels, and any angel that goes into the system, he's willing to go in and buy him back. And when he buys him back, and they get converted, they go back. That is self-existence. Ooh. You just bought yourself back because we are him. So if you come in and you buy yourself back, you're self-existent. Isn't this cool? It's so cool. All right, there it is. So those people that thought that was the one you're going to get Kleck with, nope, he didn't get me with that one. Okay, here you go. There's a dead sheep. That's a girl hugging a guy, and it's a dead sheep. If you don't see the sheep, I'm sorry. It's pretty hard not to see, but whatever. Now, let's talk about the Egyptians. Egypt is called the boundary of the enemy. And the God of the Hebrews, so when they went, they talked to Pharaoh. They're like, hey, man, we need to go worship our God. And they said, the God of the Hebrews has met with us. Okay, now see, some people go, well, Clark, it says God. Oh my, it says Elohim. It's a generic name for God as well, so relax. Okay? And they said, the God of the Hebrews has met with us. Let us go, we pray thee, 3 days journey into the desert and sacrifice unto the Lord, the self-existent eternal Jehovah, our God. So he's the head of all the Elohim because he's the self-existent eternal Jehovah. Elohim, he's the only one that can come in and buy it back. So he's the head. Get it? Well, guess what? To those guys, because they started the host body system like the Egyptians. They're always coming up from the pit, starting a new host body system. Angels are always coming down into the system, getting worked, going down to the pit. Then the pit opens again and they come out again. They get destroyed and it happens again. It never ends. Just saying. The Lord's let me solve it. Okay, now, if you're the Egyptians and you have all your gods and the angels that are coming down into the system getting worked, well, our God is God from the other side. You get it? Because their God is from that side. Satan, you know, Ra, all of that multiplicity of Elohim from the pit. Our God is the God of the other side, the Hebrews. You get it? One's from one side, one's from the other side, and here I am stuck in the middle with you. Yes, perfect, perfection. Okay, see, look, the word Hebrew, it means on the opposite side. The God of the Hebrews is the God of the opposite side, especially of the Jordan, usually meaning the east. Do you know that's why the Lord took me to the cemetery? And I remember on the west was all the dead people's heads facing west. And then he told me, look to the right. And there was only one name facing me, facing east, Gallagher. And it said, and he said, look up the meaning of Gallagher. And Gallagher means descendant of a foreign helper, letting me know that I'm a descendant of the one running the show from outside the system, just like the head gamer. And I listened and I documented it. And it's a proven miracle. There you go. So there it is. So our God is the God of the other side. So that's a no-brainer, right? And then, yeah, here's stupid. No more angels down on the dance floor. That's just... Okay, now Shema, O Israel. Okay, this is a phenomenal little post that I put in here, if you understand it. There are two large print letters in the first sentence, Ayin and Dalet. Okay, let's read the first part. Additionally, the Talmud points out that subtle references to the Ten Commandments can be found in the three portions, as the Ten Commandments were removed from daily prayer in the Mishnaic period. The Shema is seen as an opportunity to commemorate the Ten Commandments. There are two large print letters in the first sentence, Ayin and Daleth, which combined spell in Hebrew, this means a witness. Do you know, you see right there, Ayin? You see that letter right there? Do you know what Ayin means in Hebrew? I do. It means the eye. Because our eye becomes the witness against them in the system. Shema, O Israel, for the Lord your God is one. Ayin, your eye becomes the witness against them. That's why if your eye be single, your whole body's full of light. You get it? Y'all should open that up and go, just read it. It means witness, and thus the idea conveyed that through the recitation and the proclamation of the Shema, one is a living witness testifying to the truth of its message, and the Ayin, which means your eye. Modern Kabbalistic schools, namely that of the Ari, teach that when one recites the last letter of the word Ekad, meaning the one, he is to intend that he is ready to die into God. Wow, that's just fascinating. Okay, now, let me see what this one is. If thine eye be single, your whole body shall be full of light. Your eye is double, but when it becomes single, you become a witness to God. Get it? You are my witnesses, declares the Lord. Why? Because our eyes have been redoubled. Jesus, the self-existent eternal Jehovah who opens wide the dungeon. Let's go to Isaiah 60. You ready? Let's do that. Let's go to Isaiah 60. This is awesome, man. It's just flowing out. It's so easy. It's so easy now. It's so easy. Oh, glory to God. I think it's Isaiah 60. Maybe it's 61. Let's see. Here we go. And the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. So the Spirit of who? So Jesus spoke these words in Luke. The Spirit, the Ruach of who? It doesn't say, ready? It doesn't say the Ruach Elohim, which is what Genesis 1 says. That was Elohim starting the trap. Anyone that can't get over it, you're just lost in your dogma. Okay, ready? The Spirit of the Lord God. So the Spirit of the Adonai. So see, it says Adonai. It means the Lord is a proper name of God. But then look at the word God, all capitals. Jehovah, self-existent. Look, the self-existent, eternal Jehovah, which is Jesus. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord, the self-existent, eternal Jehovah, has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. He is to proclaim liberty to the captives. Look at the word captives. To transport into captivity. Really quick. Transported from where, you might ask? Oh, heaven. Captives in a host body. The host body is your captivity. Okay, ready? And the opening of the prison to them that are bound. Ready? Redoubled. The opening of a dungeon. Salvation from sin. Ready? To open the senses, especially the eyes. Ready? To redouble the eyes. Salvation from sin. If thine eye be single, your whole body is full of life. To them that are bound, to yoke or hitch, that are fastened and joined in battle, because you are bound to a demon in battle within your host body and you're an angel. It's proven now. I'm looking at you. It's proven. Using the word of the Lord God. You want to see some more? You want to see some more cool stuff? Freak out! This is so cool. Okay, ready? Now, let's do it. Let's just get them in the corner, and this is where you don't let up. Now, look, I just showed you a scripture that said you're bound in battle. Here's an angel bound to a demon, and the demon's got a wanker. And the devil's looking to the wanker for where he gets all his, you know, where he gets his energy, because he eats your soul, which is started in the form of semen going into an egg. That's where your energy, your soul comes from. It's provided. Okay, ready? Now watch. And you chose it. Now ready? Let's look at all the obviousness. Let's turn this. See the devil looking up from hell? Going, this is my system right here. I got my demon wanker and I got my angel in chains. And they're bound together. They're yoked together. See, they're yoked to, or hitched together in battle. See right there? There it is. So he's going to open this dungeon right here because the devil's just waiting for the end of this battle. So the worm that's in the pit can suck up all the energy. And there's the worm that's on this same tattoo. You just got to turn it upside down to see the worm that's eating all the stuff. Oh, by the way, Venom, Samael, likes to eat the same stuff. I told ya. Uh-huh. So now, so here we go. Here is the big bug in the Vatican eating the same stuff. They're all eating light energy in the form of semen. Sperm. Now let's go back to Kehinde Wiley doing his interview about Barack Obama's portrait and his other portraits with sperm. I like to take little shots of masculinity and the bravado, so I put sperm in my painting. What do you mean, little shots? You like to take, what do you mean, like, you like to mock male energy? I like to take little shots at the masculinity and the bravado. Because I'm the other energy and we're killing you guys. Ooh. What's going on in the end of the world? Let's have Drag Time Story Hour. It'll be really good. You may not even know. Your kid may be a tranny. We're just trying to help you find out. See, because she thinks she owns them all because the host body system belongs to her. And so those children in all these classes, that monster looks at as hers. And the most dangerous place in the world is between a mother and her children. So if you think those kids belong to you that you're trying to protect that are in those classes, you better think again because she's got legal title deed to their bodies. Now it all makes sense, doesn't it? Why would the federal government protect Drag Time Story Hour? Are you freaking whack? No, they're ours. Oh, I got it. Get it? Kelopop. Pfft, Baphomet. Duh, bug, semen, wankers. Shit. It's like, okay, got it. Now, let's do it. I've got some. Okay, wait a minute. Wait, I'm missing like a page. Where's my stuff? Okay, wait a moment. I'm missing my Ian Bud Light stuff. One moment, please. Okay, now y'all remember where Mr. Ian... Okay, now I told you I was going to share with you how the Lord showed me full circle. So I watched the movie Free Guy last night, and the Lord just spoke to me through the whole movie. It was like, I get it. Now, you know Ian goes to a party. He takes the bait from Kelly, which means female warrior. Hey, if I give you this... Are you ready for whatever happens? Like I'm going to take you to a party with a bunch of twins and you're going to lose your soul and we're going to collect it at the end of an earth cycle. Are you ready for that, Ian? And Ian's like, yeah, I'm okay. I'm up for it. And so Ian goes on his date with Kelly, but somehow she hands him off on a date with two twin girls. And then he goes to a sudden death ping pong match with Arnold Schwarzenegger where everyone's going to suddenly die because once they get cut loose there. But I was watching that in the little video I showed you guys tonight, and the Lord told me to pay attention. Look at the SE plus PE. See it right there? SE plus PE. And the Lord told me to pay attention, Jonathan. When I hear that, that means I'm going to lay hands on somebody. I'm going to end up in Chinati in the desert. You know, Kill Devil Hills. When the Lord tells me to pay attention, that's when I'm like, here we go. Okay. Ooh. Okay. So here's what he told me to pay attention to. SE plus PE. You see it right there. Now, if you want the full effect, watch, sit down and watch Free Guy right now. And then after you watch Free Guy, come back and restart my video right now and then watch this. Okay. So after I watch Free Guy, the Lord tells me now, okay, again, ready? If you want the full effect that I got, this is the way the Lord did it. He had me watch Free Guy, and it was supernatural just the way he got it done. So I watched Free Guy, and I was like, then I come down here to do a video for you guys last night, but it wasn't happening because of just exhaustion and just too much new stuff coming in. And so the Lord told me to pay attention to SE plus PE and to look it up in the language I taught you. SE plus PE. Okay, well, you really got to pay attention to detail if you're looking at something like this, and you better have a really interesting ability to pull a rabbit out of a hat because I'm like, okay, ready? Let's do it. SE plus PE. S is the number 19, and E, okay, ready? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S. 19, that's S. And then E is the number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, SE is 195. Watch. Don't forget, you just watched all of Free Guy. It means exactness, strictness, accuracy, exactness, attention to detail, scrupulousness, accuracy, exactness, attention to detail, scrupulousness. Now, don't forget, I just watched Free Guy, and I heard the Lord tell me, Jonathan, pay attention. Okay, so I'm like, okay, that's interesting. Now look at Now look at PE plus PE, all right? Well, so I had 199, which, or 195, which means preciseness, exactness, attention to detail. And then 165, aeon, which means a space of time and age, a cycle of time, especially of the present age as contrasted with the future age, as one of a series of ages stretching to infinity, an age, an era of time, the time period. So, it's characterized by Christ baptizing all believers in the Holy Spirit, engrafting all believers into his mystical body with all the marvelous privileges that go with that. Now, did you hear what I just said? The Lord told me, Jonathan, pay attention to that on the wall after watching Free Guy. Okay, well, I already know the mystery of the whole world. So when the Lord tells me to pay attention to something, it must be important. So I looked up and I'm like, okay, that's crazy. 195 means preciseness, exactness, attention to detail. Do you know anyone that has pretty good attention to detail? Okay, so he made me. And then 165 PE means all the believers that have been baptized by Christ with the Holy Spirit that get to go into his eternal kingdom. Go watch Free Guy right now, quick. And then I was like, okay, that's crazy. And then I heard the Lord say, well, do what it says, add them together. And I'm like, oh, wow, okay, so preciseness, exactness, attention to detail, and all the believers that have been baptized in Christ that are in this game that we're in, this game called life, where there is a omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent God that sees everything and knows everything. And now he's telling me, now add those two together, because when you add PE, when you add SE 195 plus PE, let me do it right here on my phone so you can see it. So we'll do it right here. Okay, I'll go to my calculator. Are you guys having fun? Okay, so ready? I'll do 195 plus 165. You can do it on your calculators. And it means 360. So 360. You know what 360 means, right? You've come full circle. What's going on in the Ian Bud Light situation, though? Well, see, it has to do, he's integrated it with what's going on in the commercial. Where is Ian on his way to? Well, he's on his way to a sudden death match with Arnold Schwarzenegger, where the wall falls down, and then he finds himself on stage with One Republic, and they'll be counting stars. How many angels they killed in the whole system? Because that's what they do at the end of an era. Once the wall comes down and everything happens and the fabric is ripped down like Jonathan Cleck's doing for you right now. Once that wall comes down and you can see through the whole deal, it's like, oh, crap. Then you're on stage. You're me. We're all on stage with One Republic, a unified group of them. And they're singing, "We'll Be Counting Stars," that they murdered. Which is us. Yay. But then I heard the Lord say, it's bigger than that. Make sure you look up 360 Strong's. And I was like, oh, wow. To unloose for departure. I unloose. Unloosed for departure. Depart. Return. From Anna. Anna Luo. The desire to depart and be with Christ, to unloose for departure. I unloose, unloose for departure, depart, return of Christ. Anna, which is up, Luo, which is really weird because just my relationship with a girl named Lou, Lou. There I called her Lou or Louie. Anna Luo. Full circle. Okay. Now, someone sent me a very nice bear, and I was going to go grab it and hug it because I want to hug your bear, but I also want to get this video up. I love you in Christ. The two have become one. If you've been made whole in Christ, you had one eye that was up. You had one eye that was down. The one that was down got inverted. Your eyes became single. And you're a child of the Lion of the tribe of Judah now. And you can go home. I love you in Christ. I believe he's calling us home here real soon. I truly believe it. Okay. He doesn't say pay attention like that. And you cannot add up this kind of... I mean, who could even deliver... who could intersect these data points? Anyway, all right, guys. I love you in Christ. That's it. I just love you. Peace and grace.